My people, thank you very much for turning to my journey. Today we are going to talk about world on me. If you have not yet subscribed, what are you waiting for? If you have subscribed, thank you very much for being a family. We start the new series called The Bread of Life, So in today's topic, we're going to talk about world on me. This is found in one of my books called What is Life in chapter 6. Anyway, if you look at world war me, we are fighting a war in ourselves. What is a war? A war is a holistic combat, fighting, struggle, arm, conflict, battle, campaign, externally or internally. War is within ourselves, and after that, you express to people around us, then our city, the country, then the continent, and then the entire world. An ocean was formed by a drop of water. Soon it became an ocean, and no water could believe that. My dear, every anger in you has to be taken by the power of the Holy Ghost. Childhood trauma will become adulthood giant, my people, if the Holy Spirit does not take control. In the war, we have two wars that have been fought. We have World War I from 1914 to 1916, and we have World War II from 1939 to 1949. In France, Marie Antoinette was one of the causes, and one of the causes of their war was selfishness, which in France, Marie Antoinette was so much extravagant. The country economy became so low, and this called for war. She was killed with her husband. Most people buy what they don't want, my people, and what they need. People will spend more than they earn. I'm telling you, this will make them to be in debt, and credit card company will be after them, and there will be so much disturbed. This will have internal anger, and suddenly they will transfer it to other people. This is what is happening in our community. African leaders give away their subjects for slavery because of selfishness. Selfishness is one of the things that will cause war within us. And they give money, and they have been given money and wine by Europeans. This selfishness actually led to separation of families, and new generation was formed through many countries like the United States, Britain, the island around the United States. Countries like Sierra Leone and Liberia were being formed as a result of selfish leader. My people, that's why I'm telling you, being selfish, selfishness is one of the main cause we fight ourselves. 2 Samuel 12, 7, 7 to 9. 7 said, then Nathan said to David, "You are the man. This is what the Lord, the God of Israel, said. I anointed you over Israel, and I deliver you from the hands of Saul. I gave your master's house, that's it, to you and your master's wife in your arms. I gave you the house of Israel and Judah. And if this has been too little, I will have given you even more." My people, David was selfish by killing Uriah's wife. He killed and take his wife. David killed Uriah and take Uriah's. David was very selfish, I'm sorry, by killing Uriah and taking his wife. David had so many wives, but decided to kill Uriah and take one of his wives. At the end, David suffered in his old age as a result of being selfish. Selfishness, you have the afterlife, what is going to happen to you. You can see that his own son Absalom wanted to kill him and become the king while the father is still on the throne. Incest was practiced among David's children because of that selfishness David practiced. David cried and begged God to help him. This was difficult, but it happened. David had to suffer all the things of God. God has forgiven him. My dear, we have to be careful with the way we treat people. We also have to be careful and grateful with what God has given us. Selfishness made David to commit adultery and murder because he was trying to hide from the war. Oh, he was trying. My dear people, if you have committed any sin, just repent rather than doing another evil to cover it. The sin can never be hidden. My dear people, at times it is very difficult to confess a sin. God is powerful and God can undo, God can forgive. Whatever the situation is, God will forgive. Rather than adding it on top another sin, everything has its own way. It's just better to confess and be free from the sin. Jealousy has dangerously impact because people who are selfish commit murder. You see, as Cain killed Abel because of selfishness, his life became a misery because he has committed murder. Selfishness is a very dangerous aspect that we have to be very careful. My dear people, if someone is more prosperous than you, you just need to come and ask the person to teach you what he did and copy, rather than be jealous, which is very disastrous. This selfishness of David caused war in his own house and nation. Cain caused war within himself and has become wanderer, having no specific destination and no peace till he died. You see, because of war on me, war on me. What are you fighting for? Which type of selfishness do you have? What type of thing do you desire to have? You cannot be fighting yourself. War on me cannot be practiced. War on me. You have to let everything go. Let it go. Just selfishness. You see our, when I went and talk about slave, how slave come about. Because our forefathers, the leaders were greedy. They were selfish because of the wine they would be given by the red people. And they decided to sell their own people. They ought to be the protector, but they were giving out. Just like David, instead of protecting Uriah, who was one of his army, David decided to sleep with Bathsheba. Bathsheba was the... Uriah was married to Bathsheba, and Bathsheba is the granddaughter of Ahithophel, one of the David's spokesman. He was like a prophet to David. And you know, David had to kill Uriah in order to take Bathsheba when Bathsheba became pregnant, because she did not want the public disgrace. You see that because David was being selfish at this moment. David was being, and you see what selfishness. God called David a man after my heart. But see what selfishness happened to David. David had, there have to be battles in David's house. Even at old age, he's running and fighting. God has forgiven, but there's a price to pay behind everything we do. So today I just come to tell us that war on me. What are you fighting within yourself? What are you know? What don't? What attitude don't you don't want to allow it go? What is stressing you out? You see that because of this selfishness, Cain has to kill Abel, kill his own blood brother. Only a selfish person will kill a family person, or kill another person. So today, let's just ask God to help us. Father, help us take away selfishness. I don't want to be fighting my own self. War with me. I want to be a better person. Jesus, help me. You are listening to me. I don't know where you're listening from, but you not tune into this channel by mistake. Thank you for tuning into this broadcast. If you are listening to this broadcast, you do not just come by mistake. It was ordained by God. See, Jeremiah said, before you were born, I already know you in your mother's womb. So before this, it was already predated by God that you listen to this video. And if you're listening, you have the opportunity to listen up to this extent. You just have to pray for God to help us. We really have to take away selfishness within us, because selfishness within us, we make us to do a lot of stuff. We make us to battle within ourselves. Even sometimes the sins we committed because of selfishness. I remember even like dating that I wasn't ready to date, like start doing fornication. That was because of selfishness. I wanted to be like every other person. I wanted to be belonging. I wanted to belong to the community. I wanted to be in the midst of my friends. Which out of that fornication, it came a lot of many other negative things. It was not the right time, so I had to do a lot of craziness just because I want to belong to my community. I want to like show that
I also have a boyfriend. Me too, I have it. So sometimes we are just being selfish. Some things we don't even need them. David had everything. David did not even need Bathsheba as a wife. Cain and Abel, you see that? Cain killed Abel, but Cain too was very prosperous. In his own area, he could have been satisfied. That's when we are not satisfied with what we want. So be life is contentment. I don't know what you're not satisfied with. Life is contentment. I'm very content. As I get older, I said being very contented with what I have, whatever I have. As the Bible says, be happy for what you have. Sometimes because we are not happy, we want many, many other things. We want a big house, a big car. We want all the things all by ourselves. We want people to see us. We don't even want God to see us. Now we start doing the things which God don't even want us to do. So today, this morning, I don't know the war you're fighting within yourself. If only we change and turn back to God, He is really going to deliver us. If you're listening to this video and today is your first time, if you have not subscribed, what are you waiting for? Do not forget to subscribe and put on your notification button, because each day we come with new same or with new videos, something like this that will inspire you for the day. My people, please do not forget to share with friends and family. Thank you very much. My name is Marie Ndung, and keep watching. I want to say that if you're a Christian, if you're not a Christian, if you're a Christian but you're not born again, you're listening to me. Just say, Lord Jesus, thank you for coming to my heart as my Lord and Savior. Thank you very much. If you have watched up to this extent, if you have said this, you have given your life to Christ, look for a Bible-believing church and make Jesus the Lord of your Savior, the Lord of your life. Make Him the Savior of your life. Do not forget to join the choir, join an intercessor team. Be in something, be active in church. Marie Ndung, see you in my next video.